Hello everyone, good morning everyone. Welcome to the webinar. So this is Bruno from FeeGent. So microaspiration experiments required a high control over the forces applied to cells. So today I will present a solution for micropipette cell aspiration. So here's the presentation timeline. So I will first explain the main advantages of micropipette aspiration and why it requires a high control over the forces that are applied to cells. I will next introduce FeeGent and some of our instruments that are related to this application. And I will next cover the content of the package, including the pressure, the fluidic, and the mechanical elements. Next, I will show you how to implement the setup and how to start performing macroaspiration experiments. And finally, I will show you some typical applications that can be done with the system. So I hope this sounds interesting to you. So micropipette aspiration, it is a powerful non-invasive technique that allows to evaluate biomechanical properties of single or even multiple cells. It can be used for cell mechanical properties measurements. So in fact, many biological processes are characterized by changes in cell stiffness, for instance. And yeah, for instance, we have the cells entering mitosis or sickle cell disease, which affect the red blood cells. So these mechanical changes occur at the cell scale, and this require precise measurements to accurately quantify this cell stiffness change. So it can also be used for single cell manipulation. So indeed, this technique can allow to pick and place single cells or cluster of cells. And this can be useful, for instance, for characterizing single cell interactions. So finally, this technology also finds some applications for evaluating the cell tensions heterogeneity or for in vitro diagnostics applications. So as the mechanical properties can help to predict the viability of embryos. So micropipette aspiration is just an excellent tool for several life science applications. But this technique requires a high control over the forces that are applied to cells. So to tackle this challenge, pressure controllers are one of the ideal tools for this kind of application. So first, in fact, we need a fast response time that is necessary for minimize as much as possible the transitional states during the micropipette aspiration experiments. And also in addition to that, for performing reproducible experiments, a stable and reliable pressure should be applied. This is, for instance, usually done by using pressure systems. So FeeGent pressure controllers are, for instance, particularly suited for these applications as they allow to apply forces ranging to tens of piconewton to one nanonewton in an accurate fashion. So to provide the ideal solution for microaspiration experiments, we provide a micropipette aspiration package. So it allows to manipulate and characterize cells at the single cell level. And as I already said before, it's a non-invasive technique that allows to evaluate the biomechanical properties of single cells or tissue, also to evaluate the response to mechanical stimuli. So it allows for repetitive measurements as it is a non-invasive method. So repetitive measurements on the same sample and the variation in cell tension or individual cells within the tissue can be monitored over time. I will show you that in a few applications later. So using the pressure systems that provides high sensitivity and resolution. In fact, pressure instruments are the only product with the ability to control small pressure increments at low pressure. And they allow the investigation of subcellular dynamics that are not accessible using other methods such as confocal microscopy. So also this method allows for high reproducibility. So manual aspiration causes variability between the operations because the applied pressures cannot be quantified exactly. And so in opposition, using pressure controllers, we can deliver a set pressure with excellent precision. Finally, it's important to note that it's also a cost-effective method and also easy to build and operate. So this This package is compact and can fit any microscope and micropipette, and is also controlled by an intuitive software. For instance, when comparing with competitive technologies like the AFM or optical tweezers that are usually expensive and necessary specific training, and may also require a dedicated microscope, this package has some advantages compared to these different methods. So maybe you want to have a look on how the system works and how what is the functioning principle of the micropipette aspiration system. So basically, we have the aspiration and the injections that are performed by coupling the pressures that come from the hydrostatic pressure and the pressure controller. So as you can see on the scheme on the left, so we have here a reservoir that is controlled in height. So we have a linear stage that allows to control the height of the reservoir. And thanks to the hydrostatic pressure, so the pressure will be applied on the flow, on the fluid, and the fluid will flow from the reservoir to the micropipettes. So this is a positive pressure. The adiabatic pressure is a positive pressure, and this will apply a positive fluid, an injection into the pipette. So on the opposite, the system is also controlled with a pressure controller, which is also connected to the reservoir. And if we have, we can apply with the pressure controller a negative pressure. So by playing with the negative pressure and the positive pressure, we can determine when we have zero pressure at the tip of the micropipette. So this is the place where the negative pressure of the pressure controller is equal to the hydrostatic pressure due to the height difference. If the negative pressure of the controller is higher than the hydrostatic pressure, we can aspirate. And we have the opposite effect. If the pressure of the hydrostatic pressure is higher than the pressure from the controller. So I hope you understand this explanation. Let me know if you have any questions. So maybe some of you are not familiar with Fulgens. So I will introduce the company and explaining our expertise as well as our major instruments. So at Fulgens, we want to help researchers and industrials to be successful in applications where the fluid control at the microscale level is critical. So in 2006, we changed the microfluidic market by introducing the pressure-driven flow controllers as opposed to the conventional syringe pumps. So thanks to this patented technology, the experimental time of some experiments had dropped down from a few hours to a few seconds. So that allowed groundbreaking discoveries and published paper. So actually, every year, more than 250 scientific papers where our instruments are used are published. So our broad range of solutions for use in microfluidic technologies and nanofluidic applications offer greater control, automation, precision, and ease of use. So we provide end user instruments for direct control, but also industrial solutions for full integration into complex equipment. So whatever your applications, we have both the expertise and knowledge to provide you the most cost effective solution. So let's have a bit more focus on one of the most flagship technologies. So the lineup series we developed in 2017. So we developed this series to fulfill a demand for compact and modular flow controllers that could be commanded locally. So it consists of a set of modules that can be added or rearranged to meet the different experimental designs. So the FlowEasy, as I said, is one of the flagship module, and it is a standalone of compact pressure-based flow controller. So you can control the pressure using a PC, but also without a PC by adjusting the dial. So in this configuration, this device allows for pressure or flow rate control on volume dispense, which makes an ideal product for benchtop use. And of course, utilizing air pressure to drive liquid flow provide excellent flow stability and response time. So we also have some improvements, extend our lineup series over the time. And now we have a good example of that with the push-pull, which is a versatile device to alternate as needed between the pressure and vacuum through a single outlet. So I think that today Fugent is well known for its laboratory research equipment, but an important part of our business is also OEM. So indeed, we provide compact pressure sources, pressure controllers, such as our peaks, as you can see here, and valves that can be integrated into any of your machines. So in addition, Fugent propose engineering services to help you develop your machine from scratch. So we offer technical consulting, design, and integration for a variety of microfluidic machines. So our engineering team are experts in microfluidic design, mechanical and software integration, in addition to biology and application knowledge, which makes up a very versatile and capable team. So we already offered our services to startup companies that develop the system from a lab and want to build a complete machine. But we also did important instruments, machines for industry companies. So now we have covered the advantage of micropipette aspiration. I also presented our companies and our instruments. So now let's have a look on the package content. So as you can see here, the micropipette aspiration setup consists of the following elements. So a microfluidic flow controller, reservoir and a high resolution linear stage, and also tubing and fittings to connect the reservoir to the micromanipulator. And then finally, we'll have the microscope for live visualization of the experiments. So in the Fugent package, we provide all the pressure, mechanical and fluidic elements to start micropipette aspiration. So with the package, we provide this part of the instruments, and we also made a bit of research to provide the ideal micromanipulator on micropipettes. But this is not our expertise, but we can suggest the right instruments. So let's have a closer look at the content of the package. So as you can see here, first it consists of a pressure control solution. So we have here the lineup FlowEasy, a pressure controller with negative flow control, pressure control going from 0 to minus 25 millibar, allowing for a highly, highly precise pressure control for the micropipette aspiration. We also have its link module, which allows to connect the FlowEasy to the software for software measurement, for use of the software. We have the reservoir and also a vacuum pump to connect the vacuum to the pressure controller so that we can precisely control the pressure. So as you remember, we need to also precisely adjust the height of the reservoir so that we can also adjust the hydrostatic pressure. So with that, we also have a high resolution linear stage with a micron scale resolution, so allowing to make very few linear increase in term of height. And we also developed custom reservoir to connect our reservoir to this stage. And finally, we have developed a full complete tubing and filling kit. This mainly allows to inject fluids. So for the setting up step, to inject fluids within the reservoir and the micropipette holder using a sealing syringe. Here, you can see also there is a two-way valve, which allows to inject either on the reservoir part or in the micropipette holder part. So thanks to that, you don't need to take out the reservoir and to fill it again, but instead of that, just fill using this tubing and filling kit, fill again the reservoir, and then switch the valve. So as I said, in the package, it includes the pressure solution control, the linear stage, and the microaspiration tubing and fitting kits. But we also selected and recommend micromanipulators and micropipettes that perfectly fit with our package. So the combination of the elements have already been demonstrated in several research papers that I will show you later. So first, regarding the micromanipulator, so two micromanipulators are used in research papers, so along with our instruments. So the first one is from Narishige. It is the most standard micromanipulator. in which you have control of the micropipettes manually. So it is a cost-effective solution. And if you want an upgraded solution and manipulate, so make the handling in a robotic fashion, you can use the Eppendorf Transferman, which is, of course, more automatic, but of course, more expensive. Anyway, so on our Fujet Micro Aspiration Packet webpage, the two references are provided on it. So regarding the micropipettes, we also selected a micropipette supplier that has the capacity and also the knowledge to provide the right micropipette for our application. So depending on the type of cells you're working, depending on the size of the cells you're working with, they can provide different types of micropipettes. They have thousands of designs, so they will for sure find a solution for your application. So the other option here is to make the micropipettes using a pipette puller and microforge. So with this kind of device, you can produce your own micropipettes and fulfill the perfect specification you need. So there is actually on the paper the whole explanation of how to prepare the micropipettes, so including the materials that are needed and also the equipment. So this information can be found on Micropipette Aspiration, a unique tool for exploring cell and tissue mechanics in vivo, research paper, which is also anyway provided on our website package. And also, of course, the reference of the micropipette provider is also here. So I think that now we have fully covered the complete list of the items that makes the micropipette aspiration system. So let's have a look at the setup and how parts are connected together. And let's see how we calibrate the system and start the micropipette aspiration experiments. So just to make sure everyone understood, so here is the description scheme, a scheme that describes the whole setup and how it looks like in real life. So as you can see on the setup, so the pressure controller is connected to the reservoir. And so here we have the eight control linear stage that allows to control the height of the reservoir. We have the tubing and filling kit that is subsequently connected to the micro manipulator and the micro pipette. And so this is how it looks like in real life. So we have the fluid here, the linear stage here, the custom holder and the reservoir, and then connected to the pipette here. And here is the microscope for make the measurements. So as I already introduced earlier, so aspiration injection are performed by coupling pressure that originates from the hydrostatic pressure and from the negative pressure that is supplied for our pressure controller that are connected to a vacuum pump. So before performing any micropipette aspiration experiment, a calibration step is required to reach a zero flow, zero flow rate equilibrium, so that when you find the cell, you can decide either you want to aspirate or release the cell. So the calibration step simply consists of two main steps, actually. So first, the pressure controller is off, so it's turned off, and you want to adjust the height of the reservoir using the linear stage, so that the pipette will expel liquid. So once you have reached this state, you can start adjusting negative pressure using our pressure controller so that you reach zero flux or zero flow rate. So we have a little tip here. So you can use cell debris or microparticles to visualize if they are being aspirated or expelled from the micropipette. So in the ideal case, you should get a zero flux or a zero flow rate. This zero equilibrium should be obtained with a mid-negative range of our pressure controller. So in between zero to 25 millibar. So to minus 25 millibar. So ideally it should be at minus 12 millibar so that you have the higher level of control to either aspirate or inject the cell. So once the calibration step is performed, you can simply find the cell using the micromanipulator and play with the negative pressure to either aspirate or expel a cell or tissue. So I hope you understood well this calibration step. If not, feel free to ask questions at the end of the webinar again. So now I will show you some typical cell mechanical measurements that can be performed with our solution. So, for instance, here, as you can see, the first applications could be subcellular surface tension mapping. So, the idea here is to measure the surface tension between the cell surface tension. So. So what you need here is to do an aspiration of a group of cells and perform a progressive, here it's an embryo aspiration, and you will have a progressive deformation. And here, the critical pressure, which is called PC, is reached when the parts of the cells is equal to the radius of the micropipette radius. So, when using the Young-Laplace and Young-Dupuy equations, you can next determine the surface tension at the cell-cell interface. So first here, you determine the surface tension using the critical pressure, the radius of the pipette and of the cell, as you can see here. And then in the second time, so in the second phase, you can calculate the cell-cell interfacial tension as you manage already to calculate this surface tension before. So another application is to measure the cell viscosity. So here it's a bit different. So it's about some cells can be evaluated as viscoelastic materials. So here what we want to do is to perform an aspiration and then the restriction steps. So first, you aspirate by controlling the pressure with a negative pressure, and then you release the cell, and you perform a recording of this. So thanks to that, you can calculate the rates of aspiration and retraction. So by measuring with time, as a function of time, the aspiration and the retraction of the cell length within the pipette. And thanks to this equation, you can measure the viscosity of the cell. So I wanted to end this presentation by summing some papers where our devices played a key role in the research. So in the first one, a group from Institut Curie in France and the European Molecular Biology Laboratory in Germany went actually a step further and used not one but two micropipette aspiration setup and performed cell juxtaposition and manipulation to probe the cell-cell adhesions and characterize the separation forces between cells. In a second paper, a group from the Department of Biology and Biochemistry of the University of Bath from the UK performed surface tension characterization of mutant fish embryos for determining the effect of the mutation of a nuclear executor on the embryo and subsequently on the body shape. So just as a summary, so I showed you that micropipette aspiration is a powerful non-invasive technique to evaluate the properties of single cells or agglomerate of cells. Pressure controls are a very interesting system for providing the high degree of control that is necessary for this kind of application. And for that, we also provide a complete package that includes the pressure, the mechanical, and the fluidic parts for you to start the micropipette aspirations experiments. And I hope you enjoyed also the demonstration that I showed to you for different type of application that can be done with this kind of package. So with that, I would like to thank you for your attention. So I really hope you enjoyed the presentation, and I will be more than happy to answer to your questions. So you can also contact us at contacts@fujian.com, or also on my personal address, which is bruno.charletti@fujian.com, that you can also find at the bottom left of this slide. So thank you for your attention.